I challenge you, go to France and wear that. I challenge you, go to France and wear that.
What do you think you can challenge?
Go to France and wear that.
I'm very here.
Walk down the Champs-Élysées wearing that shirt.
That's not your business.
Say no more.
This is not your business. I am not Mohammed.
She's a witch.
I am not Mohammed.
You are not Mohammed?
I'm not Mohammed. Mohammed is the bitch of
Mohammed. Ummat Sayyidina Muhammad. Anti min Ummat Sayyidina Muhammad.
How are you just standing next to the person like this? Are you guys alright, bro? You guys alright? Get your camera out of my face, bro. Get your camera out of my face. Get your camera out of my face. How do you stand next to a person like this?
How?
What are you guys, bro? What are you guys? If you care too much about your blood, we don't care about our blood. We'll eat you guys alive, bruv. I swear to God the day will come. On my mother's life, bruv. Allah will eat you guys alive, bruv.
Come on,
Get away now!
Behind the police officer! He's attacking the police officer!
Oh,
They don't want to debate with you, so leave them alone.
Sir,
Well, they, other
right,
points,
I feel I am offended.
And they
can
come
you please
over to
protect
us, and we
my
don't
rights?
Ask you to take them away, and you don't take
can
them away.
Can police please protect my rights, please?
This is happening both ways.
Please protect my rights, please.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm here dealing with this incident right here, right now.
What is the incident?
There is no
what is the incident?
There is.
What is the incident?
Because people have come to me and said, you are interrupting them, you're getting in front of their
camera. It is speaker's corner.
But why do you have to do it there? Tell me.
Group is
tell
over
what?
There,
no.
I am asking them the question,
but
sir.
But why do you have to go in there and do that when they clearly don't want you there? Tell me.
Oh, actually, show me the invitations any of them received, sir. Don't ever talk to me like that again, sir. Don't ever bully me again, sir. Don't ever bully me, okay? I'm saying this last time. I fed up with your bullying me.
Clearly, they don't.
It is speaker's corner. It is called hecklers.
I'm not talking about that, am I? I'm talking about what's happening right here right now. I do not care what race, religion, creed.
It looks like you do care.
What? No, I do not care.
So tell me what was
what
my argument over
what
that?
What I care is about you encroaching on that and creating a potential public order situation.
Excuse me?
Do I have to repeat myself?
Yes, please.
I'm wary of you going in there, encroaching on their space and creating a public order situation.
Show me. Show me what I have done wrong.
I've had several people come to me.
Sir, I am right now. I am offended that you are so close to me. I am offended
away.
By all these Muslims. So it is the same. If they are offended, if they don't want to talk, they will walk away. They put 13 cameras. They don't want to walk
why
away.
Why do you have to go
because I am asking the questions about
it.
It's speaker's corner, sir.
You want to be paraded every week, but not paraded.
Why are you not protecting my freedom of speech? Why are you not protecting my freedom of speech, sir?
What do you mean your freedom?
Why are you not protecting my freedom of speech? They did
not
allow me to speak.
I'm
not saying
you are.
You are. You are.
To support whatever the Muslims are asking you to do. This is what's happening week after week.
What is the public order?
Well, there's a lot of people. You feel one thing, they feel another.
So what? It's speaker's corner. It's speaker's corner. Do you have new rules for the speaker's corner? It does matter. It's speaker's corner, sir. It does matter.
Because
he's harassing me, like. Oh, I'm so offended. He's harassing me right now, sir. Can you please practice the public order for him?
I'm dealing with you.
Yo, why go and tell them if they feel they are harassed, they will walk away.
She's harassing.
How is she provoking them? They're not provoking her.
It is speaker's corner. It is speaker's corner.
Come over.
It is speaker's corner. I am asking him. I am asking him to fill the holes in the Quran. There are problems. It was Muslims who told us there are problems. I am asking him to fix it.
Keep walking away then. And that will solve everything, won't it?
Why, sir?
To talk
why?
To
yeah.
Because then I
want to
we
stand here.
Deploy our resources properly and not
sir.
Deal with you.
She walked
sir.
Away.
You are not dealing with
keep
me, sir. I am not
away.
A problem.
Yes,
don't talk to me
because
like that. Don't bully me. Please don't bully me. Don't bully me.
You
are bullying me. As well as you are protecting their
everyone,
whatever it is,
everyone.
You are not protecting my law,
I
my rights.
In the inflammatory party
no, sir.
At this point, which is
no, no, sir.
Yes,
no,
you
sir.
On existing
where are you? Where are you? At speaker's corner.
Yeah,
people are coming to me all day. They weren't speaking, they were starting the conversation.
Okay.
That's very different.
And if you come to play at
speaker's
day,
corner, it is allowed.
You're not taught to listen to me, are you?
That is allowed at speaker's corner. Give me the rules for the speaker's corner, sir.
What do you mean the rules for speaker's corner?
Tell me, what is heckling at speaker's corner? How did people get their right to freedom of speech at speaker's corner,
they
please?
I don't want to speak to you.
Then why are you here? Why did you come specially to tell where is that complaining guy? Where is that Mr.
Well, you've just
gentleman.
Accused him of harassing you, so you can't go looking for him now, can you? What I think you
don't
need to do...
Don't bully me, sir. Don't
just,
bully me.
I'm not trying to bully you,
you are
I?
Bullying me, sir.
No, I'm clearly not.
You are,
I'm
sir.
Just speaking to you.
No, sir, you are bullying me.
How am I bullying
and
you?
And you think you are getting away with that. Well done.
I don't understand what you're trying to say. What I'm trying to do is prevent any disorder happening. And
then,
when you were
then go and talk to people. Go and talk
well,
to people
I'm
who are
to you.
Shutting down my freedom of speech.
To you.
I'm not shutting down anyone's freedom of speech at speaker's corner,
no,
sir.
But when you're encroaching on what they are doing...
What they are doing, sorry, what are they doing? They are here for the debates and discussions. I am here for debates and discussions.
But
there is nothing different.
But they very quickly, and police explained to you earlier today already, I know this, they've very quickly told you they do not want to debate with you.
At
I could tell
corner.
That within seconds of being
it's
here.
It's a speaker's corner.
It doesn't mean they have to debate with you.
Of course they don't have to, but I have right
alone.
To ask my questions.
Leave them alone. No,
that's
it's
that,
not,
that's
it
what
doesn't
the
mean
is about, to speak and debate.
Well, if they don't want to, then they don't have to.
It's made speaker's corner.
Okay. Oh, I don't care.
Why don't you care? Because it isn't.
Did you say all
I have the hatred for Hatton?
What did you say?
I saw this lady in the middle of a crowd that clearly did not want her there.
And that's because the rules of Speaker's Corner now.
For Hatton.
Well, I don't know the rules of Speaker's Corner. I know the rules of public disorder. And I know what inflames situations and what doesn't.
As I said last week, how many times has Hatton attacked anybody here?
No.
Never, never. Hatton's been attacked or threatened. Hatton's been threatened and attacked several times.
The guys on the tree, is that
there's
like
the problem. You don't deal with the people causing the problem. You deal with the victims of the problem. And until you start dealing with the people causing the problem, it's going to get worse and worse and worse. Until you start dealing with the problem, you've got to. Until you deal with the problem and the people that are causing the violence, it's going to get worse and worse and worse.
Hatton is poking a hornet's nest. Please deal with a hornet's nest. That's all I say. Don't deal with Hatton.
You
might figuratively be using a stick to poke that hornet's nest, but the hornets need dealing with because they're the violent ones.
The hornets are the
And
Muslims.
I think that's a good simile to describe what we're all facing here. Deal with the hornets.
Deal with
not
the
person
Muslims.
Who's yeah, poking them within the rounds of free speech, within the rounds of Section 29J of the Public
violence.
Order Act, which I hope you're aware of.
Not
any ridicule or criticism on
let's
the basis
let's
of
just
religion.
Remind that order, actually. I've got that in my back.
And the House of Lords, they actually did some good when they added that section to the Public Order Act. She is working, behaving completely within the bounds of Section 29J, but there are some people that don't like it. And those people react violently. Deal with the violent people.
Well, no one's reacted violently yet,
yeah.
Which I'm eternally grateful.
Not this week.
Absolutely. We all what are. I'm trying to do is prevent that this. Yeah,
but don't
like
do
this
it
happening.
By denying Section 29J. Nothing in the Public Order Act prevents criticism,
that's the
ridicule.
Public Order Act of 1886, isn't it?
No, but that, but Section 29... You don't know about it. I can't believe you don't know about it. You're here for public
do you
order.
Do you know all the laws?
And you don't know... I know Section 29J. Much more recent than Redmond Bate, and we all know the Redmond Bate case was another case which protected
again.
The right to offend. You don't know the Redmond Bate case either.
I'm a police officer, not a lawyer. I don't know the intricacies.
But these are basic aspects of free speech. Anyway.
That's true. I completely agree with you with that. When somebody, anybody, encroaches into another demonstration.
Wait,
uses any language and might be interpreted as threatening, abuses, or insulting, and causes harassment, alarm, or distress. That's when we breach, when we violate. Yes, I know, but.
There is no but,
I don't think that.
There is no but that speaker's
that
gonna
fall beginning of it.
You are taking my freedom of speech away.
The Public Order Act has greater value than that. That supersedes all of the Public Order Act. It was added by the House of Lords.
Because of praying, especially on a hot day, I've got to.
But don't
do
when
something.
People approach you and say, oh, there's a guy.
I know there's two
trouble.
Sides to every story as well. I do know that.
But you're always reacting to your mom.
Sometimes it helps.
She's been removed for her safety. Have you ever been charged with any conviction in the Speaker's Corner? No, she's never been charged. She's been removed from the Speaker's Corner for her safety, right? From obeying mom.
Like, you have to understand, she's done it herself. Right.
Well, I'm not
what does that mean? Excuse me, what does that mean she's doing to herself? I am not the one who is bringing people to attack me. I am not the one who is paying people from Scotland to bring it here. Don't play that thing. Are you saying, oh, woman has been raped because she was wearing this skirt? What a stupid thing to say in front of the officer, and they just turn the blind eye because it's the freedom of speech. What a stupid thing. No one cares about my rights. Here's the problem. Almost a year ago, Muslims expressed that there are holes in the narrative. So don't take my clip, please. Approximately a year ago, it was Muslims who told us there are holes in the narrative.
Preservation of Quran is, for example, Hafsa and Asim, the way Hafsa and Asim. Do you see it as preserved munazzal from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or do you not see that as munazzal?
But again, Allah has tested me because I'm Yasir Khadi. All those other emails were ignored. And it's, you know, my bits and pieces. So one of the brothers, he did something, again, unethical. He was expelled from the list, and the list was basically banned because of that. Stopped because of that. He couldn't refute to my argument. So he sent it to one of your madkhalis in England. And so then, of course, this madkhali gave it to the other one. And so obviously, everything, all whatever broke loose. But again, this was not something I brought up in public. And I would never bring it up in public. And I don't think it is wise to bring it up in public. Now, as for the issue itself, every single student of knowledge knows, who studies ulum al-Quran, that the most difficult topics are ahruf al-qira'at, and the concept of ahruf and the reality of ahruf and the relationship of the Uthmanic Mus'haf with the ahruf and the preservation of the ahruf. Is it one? Is it three? Is it seven? And the relationship of the qira'at to the ahruf. This is a topic that when you're the beginning student of knowledge, you're like, what is all of this going on here? When you go a little bit more, you learn to simply memorize what your teachers say and regurgitate it out, and you don't fully comprehend. When you do a deep dive is when things get very, very awkward and difficult. And this isn't new. This is from the time of the Sahaba in the Sahih or the Hasan Hadith of Ubay bin Ka'b, the Hadith of the Ahruf, that when the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the issue of Ahruf and that there are different Ahruf and whatnot, this is in the version of Muslim Imam Ahmad, Ubay bin Ka'b says, authentic Hadith, فَدَخَلَ فِي نَفْسِي شَكْ. In my heart, a doubt came that I hadn't had about Islam since the days of Jahiliyyah. This is not a joke, brothers and sisters. The issue of Ahruf and Qira'at caused confusion to somebody whom the Prophet ﷺ said, if you want to listen to the Quran directly, listen to Ubay. Ubay is not some even average Sahabi. He is the Qari of the Quran. He is the master. He is who he is. And he goes, فَدَخَلْ فِي نَفْسِي شَكْ. What is all of this stuff? Now, for the first time, I'm telling you here, what was the crisis? I mentioned it, referenced it, but I never explicitly said it. Why didn't I say it? Because it should not be said in public. But unfortunately, these brothers, because they released the emails, so then I have to then get it. This was the issue. That the issue of ahruf and preservation and qira'at and relationships between them, these are very, very difficult issues. And the most advanced of our scholars, they're not quite fully certain how to solve all of the unanswered questions in there. Ibn al-Jazari, who without a doubt is the greatest scholar of qira'at for the last 1,000 years, Ibn al-Jazari famously writes, I have been thinking and pondering, I've been thinking and pondering about the issue of the ahruf and qira'at for over 35 years. Nayfan wa 30 sana, he said, right? And confused and whatnot, then finally, this is my response. And by the way, seven, all later scholars say, well, that doesn't make any sense. So they kind of dismissed even that. After 35 years, the greatest scholar of Qira'at.
Some accepted it.
It doesn't answer the question. Anyway, I don't want to get into that issue.
Okay, fine.
Why do I not want to get to that issue? Here's the point. These issues should only be discussed amongst people who know what the Qira'at are, and who understand some of these questions that are being raised.
So is what you're saying, the shek that came, or not the shek, but the crisis that you had was in relation to this question of the relationship between the ahruf and the qira'at, basically?
No. The crisis I had wasn't that. The crisis I had was, that was what generated. But what was the crisis? The crisis, traditional understandings of ahruf and qira'at cannot answer some of these pressing questions that are now being poked by our people outside of, by our academics, not our, by their academics outside of the faith tradition. You see, in a Muslim environment, there's always some respect that we have for the Quran. We should. In a Muslim environment, we'll press a little bit, and then we'll say, okay, khalas, sami'na wa ata'na. And that's great, alhamdulillah. When you go to academia, they don't have that red line. And they're going to just, you know, the famous story of the emperor with no clothes. They're going to just point out, no, that doesn't make any sense. Well, that's not true, and this and that. And they'll bring issues, which I'm not going to mention explicitly, that you know are true because they're in your own books. They're not inventing anything new. They'll bring you riwayat, and they'll bring you athar, and then you add to that very well-known issues of, I don't even want to be explicit. And then you bring on top of that makhtutat, and then. And it's very clear to you and to every single very advanced student and specialist that the standard narrative has holes in it. That's what I'm going to say. The standard narrative does not answer some very pressing questions. Okay? This is what I'm going to say. And
but I think here we
Let me finish this, Sam, because this is a very important point. I'll let you kind of let me finish this. And by the way, if you are following online media and articles and whatnot, this is no longer hidden news. More and more professors and academics are writing stuff, and it's being publicized on Twitter in the last two, three years. I have had at least, I'd say, a dozen people tweet at me like specific articles, like how do you answer this, and you know, about ulum al-Quran, about qiraat, about makhtutat, about issues, you know, these are now well known within the Western academy, that they're bringing forth issues. Their level of now knowledge is leaps and bounds above what it used to be, you know, 100 years ago. You know, you can log on to Yaqeen and he has a paper on qiraat and whatnot, and that's one interpretation that does a great service, but it doesn't answer all the questions. My point being that this issue of ahruf and qiraat has troubled the ummah from the very beginning of times. Nothing new. And there are 15 opinions about this. None of them fully answer all of the questions that are raised. Some of them answer more than others. So the issues of the relationship, of the origins, of the ikhtilaf and all of this should only be discussed amongst those who are familiar with this science. I can't answer this question in a 20-minute interview, nor is it wise to do so, which is why I never brought this topic up myself. You will not find one lecture of mine about this issue. It should never be brought up in public. And I don't like these idiots, and they are idiots, wallahi, because they're the ones who caused this. In this issue, they're utter idiots who did something haram. And I don't like saying this. This is not something you discuss amongst the masses, ya akhi. It's not wise. You don't understand qiraat. Let it be. It's wise. That's why I never did it. But what is happening in the last few years, it's not me anymore. It's the Western academics. These problems are now becoming mainstream. Twitter has so many accounts of Quran experts, and they're non-Muslims, and they're just saying things. There are books written. Yani Brill released a book by Shadi Nasir. Again, yani, read that book as well. Yani, so for those that are interested in stuff, and you'll understand that, hey, we need ulama who believe in the Quran to defend the Quran. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, ubashirukum, that our group.
Let me ask you one question to try and make this as specific as possible. I think if I were to give you a blank mushaf, yeah, and tell you to write what is munazzal verbatim from Allah into that mushaf with no human interference, would you write something which corresponds?
It's not an easy answer. It's not an easy yes or no. It is enough for the Muslim to believe that the
Quran
is...
I think this should be an easy yes or no, though. Yes, Al-Khadi. I have to...
Okay, very well. So, ya Muhammad, after we get off this phone call, me and you, let's have a number of discussions. No problem. I'm very open with advanced students.
Fill the halls. It's been a whole year with the Holy Quran. What Muslims do is, oh, Mr. Policeman, please help us. We can't answer the basic questions. Please rescue us. And Mr. Policeman comes, yep, they need rescued. But the bottom line is this, Lord Jesus Christ rescued everyone. Yet today they are running away from him. What a disgraceful day for Speaker's Corner. People turn up with their camera. They are quite happy to practice their freedom of speech. But I cannot practice my freedom of speech. Why? Because I am asking questions about Islam. Islam is so really, really awful ideology. No one can defend it. All they do is, Mr. Policeman, please defend Islam for us. You know what will happen when Islam takes over? This Mr. Policeman wouldn't be very happy at all. He's not gonna be happy. I'm not gonna be happy because my rights, basic human rights, are going to be taken away from me. Because we are turning blind eye and deaf ears at the heart of freedom of speech. Muslims cannot answer the basic question. What happens is, Mr. Policeman, please help us, we need your help. Why? Because we brought mess to ourselves by stating there are holes in the narrative, and we have no answer. Right now, all we can do is, Mr. Policeman, please help us. And thanks to God, Mr. Policeman is helping the protected group. They need very much help.
We're leaving. Bye.
That's another issue.
And Charlie, Section 29J.